No, we're waiting for the last count here now, but we do know that you're going to be taking a seat in Lifford for Sinn Féin. You must be delighted.
Oh, absolutely delighted. Delighted for myself, but absolutely delighted for the people that were behind me in this campaign. A very strong party and a very strong campaign team. And just there's too many to mention, but a big, big thank you to my brother Raymond, who was the DOE in the election, and he's done a powerful job. Got the vote out, and as I say, to me, it's not a shock that we won the seat here today, because you've seen the trend that's happened all over the country. Sinn Féin are on the up, and I would say they'll stay there for a long time, you know.
Absolutely, and you're right, because we spoke to Piers Doherty at the Oral Leisure Centre yesterday. I mean, I think there's 11 candidates running, and he was hoping that 9 of them are going to be elected. I'm not sure if that's going to happen, but it's going to be close to it, which is a fantastic achievement for the party.
We set out to... I thought, honestly, we're talking about maybe 9 out of 11. Yeah. And I think we're still in a shout for 10.
Pretty much.
10 out of 11.
Yeah.
And that's some achievement. It's unbelievable. Yeah. Like, it's unbelievable.
And Mick McMahon, we spoke to him, he was magnanimous in saying he's delighted that you're getting the seat, that there was just the one seat there for Sinn Féin. But you two obviously worked very well together, because his transfer certainly was a huge help to you.
Well, of course, and that just shows you what kind of a man Mickey McMahon is. He went out and he asked for the number 2 for me, as I did down our area. And it just shows that, you know, Mickey's not gone, because Mickey will run, and I guarantee you we'll take the 2 seats the next time around, you know, so yeah. No doubt about that. You know.
It's a watershed weekend for Sinn Féin, really, in this county, isn't it, Noel? Because you've had a lot of good people working on the ground. You've had high-profile people like Padraig McLaughlin and Piers Doherty. There's been very good councillors there doing tremendous work. But you're going to now with a real responsibility to this council if you take 10 seats in there.
Yeah. Well, it's just that, well, I would, when you mentioned Piers and Padraig McLaughlin, they're great help to us, like, you know. And then of course we have a responsibility, but people know that we will work for the people on the ground. And as I say, we set out to get 10 out of 11, and we still hope to take 10 in, you know.
Yeah. So. Well, what were the things really that people were saying to you on the doorsteps that really they felt we needed change for?
Well, you know, when I mentioned first, you know, I didn't think this was an election as such. It was an election on austerity. Like, did the people want it? Were the people going to vote for the party that has let it out, and the party that the previous government? I didn't think so. I thought the votes were going to come to us, and as I say, we're showing an alternative, and I'm sure when we get in there, we'll just prove it, you know.
You're right, because Fianna Fáil got it at the last general election, and Fine Gael and Labour have certainly got it in these elections, local elections, and the European elections. And democracy is a wonderful thing when people have the opportunity to actually tell people what they're thinking.
Oh yeah, well, with people, you know, we could see it clearly. You can see it clearly in every election. The people are talking, they want change, and we hope to deliver that change for them, you know.
Bit of pressure now, because this has been a pressure time in the last 10 or 12 weeks. You've got over the worst of it here now this evening, but there's work ahead now, because the expectation will be that the people who have been sent back to Lifford are going to do a job for Donegal, Noel.
Yeah. And, you know, I'd like to also congratulate 2 other councillors that was in here today. You have 3, you know, fairly close together there. John Campbell as well there. He's an independent, and he's in the same parties as myself. And, you know, Manchardis, as I say, it's a long time since I had a councillor. And I'm originally from Inver, and I was being told there, Baim and Monaghan, that Paddy Maguire, way back, I forget what, it was the last Sinn Féin councillor, it's back in the 1920s, you know, that was in Inver, so I'm proud to be that man.
No pressure then, no?
No pressure whatsoever.
Any congratulations.
Thanks very much, Charlie.
Thank you.